Hello friends, welcome to the Viva, Voce of Anatomy. In this video, we discuss the radiological methods for the abdomen. So, the common radiological method to study the abdomen are a plain X-ray, where we are not using any radio opaque dye. Others common are a barium study, pyelography, hysterosalpingography. In these three methods, we are using a radio opaque dye. So, let's discuss first in this video plain X-ray of the abdomen. So in this video we discuss the plain X-ray of the abdomen, which is also known as a plain skyagram. Usually the plain X-ray or the skyagram of the abdomen is taken in the anteroposterior view, means the radiation from the X-ray machine is coming from the anterior side of the abdomen. It passes through the abdominal cavity and it will form on the radiological film which lies on the posterior aspect of the abdomen. Now after getting the X-ray, we are having a radiological film in which we study the different part of the abdomen. Now this film is given a different name. We discuss how this name is given. The first is a straight film. Straight film is taken in case of the acute abdomen, means if the patient comes in the emergency with the acute pain, intense pain in the abdomen, where we are not doing any preparation on the patient, straightforward we do the X-ray, plain X-ray, APV of the abdomen. That film taken is known as a straight film. The second, what is a survey film? Sometimes we do some special procedure to see the hollow organs. These are the barium studies, pyelography and hysterosalpingography. So just before injecting or using the dye, we take a plain X-ray of the abdomen, which is known as a survey film. Third is a scout film. Sometimes patient is a bedridden. He or she is admitted in the ward or the ICU. Is not able to go to the radiological department for the X-ray. In that case, we move the X-ray machine to the patient's cot and we take the X-ray. Such type of the film is known as a scout film. And the last is a KUB. KUB stands for kidney, ureter and the bladder. So when we only focus on the urinary tract, we take a KUB film. Okay, so apart from the straight film, we require the preparation for the patient. So in the acute emergency, there is no requirement of the patient. We do straightforward a straight film. But in the chronic condition, we require the preparation. Now let's discuss which are these preparation. The first thing is the antiflatulants. We give the antiflatulants to the patient for a 2 to 3 days before the procedure, before the X-ray. Antiflatulants are the agents which removes the gas, food and the fecal material from the GI tract. So it should be given 3 days prior to the procedure. This can be in the form of the enzyme preparation, charcoal tablets and the laxative. The second thing, kneel by mouth for 12 hours, means avoiding any oral feeds, whether it is a food or a fluid, for about 12 hours before doing the plain X-ray. That is kneel by mouth for 12 hours. And the third thing, in case of the, if the patient is chronic constipated, we are using a enema. SOS means as and when required. If it is required, we give the enema to the patient to clear the lower GI tract. So this is the preparation before we are doing a plain X-ray of the abdomen in the chronic case. Now we discuss the reading of a plain X-ray of the abdomen. The first thing we should see for a bony cell, which are the bones we can see in this X-ray. So the lower ribs, these are the lower rib. This is the last rib, that is the 12th rib, the 11th, 10th, 9th onwards. After the rib, identify the vertebrae. These are the vertebrae. Now we exactly have to decide the number of the vertebrae and the type of the vertebrae. So to the rib, we know articulating a thoracic vertebrae, and to the 12th rib, articulating the 12th thoracic vertebrae. So this one is the 12th thoracic vertebrae, and we know below the 12th thoracic vertebrae, this is the L1, this is the L2, L3, L4 and L5 vertebrae. Below the L5, this is the sacrum bone, fusion of the sacral vertebrae. On the either side of the sacral vertebrae, the next, that is the hip bone, and this is the upper part of the femur. Now, next thing, you have to identify the joints, possible joints. So between the ribs and the vertebrae, this is the posterovertebral joint, which is plain variety of synovial joint. Between the vertebrae, there is an intervertebral joint, which is a secondary cartilaginous joint. Between the sacrum and the iliac bone, sacroiliac joint, which is a plain variety of synovial joint. This is the hip joint, ball and socket variety of synovial joint. And this is the pubic symphysis, which is again a secondary cartilaginous joint. So after the bony shadow, you look out for a soft tissue shadow. So the first soft tissue shadow, which is lies lateral to this lumbar vertebrae, it is a psoas major muscle. This is the psoas major muscle shadow. Now here you can see the dark line on the right side and on the left side. This is the lateral border of the psoas major muscle. So this is a psoas major shadow. Now the another soft tissue shadow which can seen if the x-ray is taken at a higher level, including the lower thoracic cage, you can able to see the dome of the diaphragm. This is the left dome of the diaphragm and this is the right dome of the diaphragm. So these are the clear cut shadow, soft tissue shadow you can see in the plain x-ray of the abdomen. The last is gas shadow. So the first gas shadow you can able to see under the left dome of the diaphragm is a fundus of the stomach. This is the gas shadow in the fundus of the stomach below the left dome of the diaphragm, which already we have seen in the x-ray of the thoracic cage. Another gas shadow, these are the scattered gas shadow which can able to see in the intestine. The scattered gas shadow often intermixed with the fecal material, so it is interrupted. Here you can see the intestinal gas shadow in the abdominal cavity as well as in the pelvic cavity. Other x-rays, this is again a plain type AP view of abdomen. Here in this x-ray you can see the gas shadow in the small intestine. This will form, this is forming the uniform pattern of a gas shadow. This is known as step ladder pattern, and this is seen in the intestinal obstruction. Now this is also another plain type AP view of abdomen. Here you can able to see the gas shadow. These are the ribs, these are the vertebrae, sacrum, hip bone and the femur. Again, this is the case of the intestinal obstruction where you can see the step ladder pattern gas shadow in the intestine. And the last also, this is the plain type AP view of abdomen, a normal x-ray. Here you can see the scattered gas shadow. Here you cannot able to see the diaphragm. Here one thing you can able to see over here, this is the radio opaque structure. This is likely to be the artifact. What is artifact? It is the structure which is not lies in the body normally, but sometimes it look it is seen in the x-ray because of the wearable items like a ring, a button, a hook, a belt, etc. So it should not be confused with the internal structure of a body. So this is all about a plain x-ray of the abdomen. If you like our video, then press the like button And if you are new to our channel, kindly subscribe to our channel. Thank you.